Good morning, students. Today I am going to explain you the properties of solid, liquid and gases. In my last video I have already explained you the what is matter and their properties, how we classify that which object is matter or which object is not a matter. But you realize that everything around us is matter. Those substances which is made up of very tiny particles and those substances having mass, these substances are called matter. And matter are classified into three categories, and these three categories are solid, liquid and gases. We classify these three categories on the basis of the physical property of matter. So now, on the basis of the physical state of the matter, can be classified into three. So I have written solid, liquid and gases. So I am going to explain you why solid is solid, liquid is liquid and the gases is gases. Here it is solid, which is made up of very small particles. These are the small particles which is made up of. All this arrangement of the particle of the solid like this. You watched this figure and realized that the distance between the two particles are very less. The distance between the two particles are very less and the attraction between the two particles are very high because they are very closer to each other. So it is very tightly packed. All the particles are very tightly packed and the distance between the particles are negligible. And the attraction, the particles attract each other and the attraction between the two particles are very high. That's why this is solid. And move on to liquid. This is a liquid and the arrangement of the particles are like this. Yes, this is the arrangement of the particles of liquid. These particles are not tightly packed like solid. They having distance between them. The particles having distance between them. That's why the intermolecular attraction between the two particles are less than solid. They having attraction. They have attract between the two particles. But the attraction of these two particles are less than solid. Now I am going to move on the gases. The particles of the gases are arranged like this. There is negligible, no attraction between the two particles of a gas. The attraction between the particles are negligible. That's why the particles of the gases are moving randomly here and there. And their space between the two particles are very high. That's why they haven't any attraction and that's why they are moving freely. So that's why gas diffuses. The diffusion held in gas very fast because the particles are moving continuously but their attraction is negligible. So according to their arrangement of particles, why we watch any object and we told that it is a solid. When the glass of water is present, we told that it is a liquid. And here oxygen is present and I am taking continuously oxygen, we told that it is a oxygen gas. Oxygen is a gas. So why we call that it is a gas, why we call it is a liquid, why we call it is a solid? Only due to the arrangement of their particles. So now I am going to explain you the properties of solid, liquid and gases one by one. I am going to explain the properties of solid, liquid and gases one by one. So, and also differences are written here. So, I am going to first tell you the properties. So, properties are there. Solid. Solid are fixed, having fixed state. You all know that solid are tough, it having fixed state. The shape, if they have a shape, then it is a fixed. Now, liquid. Liquid does not have a fixed shape. You all know that when we put the liquid in a container, you realize that it take the shape of the container. So as same as liquid, liquid does not have a fixed shape. But the gases also don't have fixed shape. In further I was told you that due to the arrangement of particles, their properties are different. They all are matter, but due to the arrangement of particles, solid, in solid particles are very tightly packed, that's why they having fixed shape. In liquid, the particles are arranged not closer like solid, so that's why they don't have fixed shape. And in gases, the particles are very free, they are moved randomly, that's why they don't have fixed shape, their particles are moving randomly here and there. So now the next point is volume. Solid having fixed volume, liquid also having fixed volume, and gases does not have fixed volume. One thing I want to explain you that if we have a container and the container capacity is 1 liter, then we only, the container only contain 1 liter of liquid. But liquid, in the case of liquid, the container filled with the use of 1 liter. But in the case of gas, when we put only 100 gram of liquid, gases in the container, it's completely filled. But when we use 500 gram of gas in the same container, it also completely filled. Means they don't have fixed volume. Another is compressibility. Yes, we are unable to compress solid very much. Little bit, very little bit, because you all know that particles, the one particle and one, the another particle, the particles are tightly packed. So that there is no space between the two particles, then how we compress each these particles? So the due to the arrangement of that type of arrangement, solid are not compressible. But in liquid, you all know that this is the one particle and this is the another one. The distance between the two particles, there is little bit gap between the two particles, so we are able to compress. So that's why in liquid we can compress moderately. But in the case of gases, you realize that we are able to compress a lot, because there is lot of distance between one particle and another particle. So we are able to compress. So gases are compressible, easily compressible. Now the next topic is density. First, I want to tell you what is density. The number of particles present in a cubic centimeter of a matter. A number of particles present a cubic centimeter of a matter. And the density means those number of, more number of particles are present in a particular substance, that it is denser. And the substance having less number of particles, so this substance is less dense. So the number of particles are very high in solid, because the particles are very tightly packed. You all know that if you take a iron piece, or you realize that it is very heavy, and if you take a cube of ice, you realize that in the same volume, you realize that iron piece is very heavy, heavier than the ice cube, because iron cube is denser than the ice cube, because it is liquid, it converted into solid, but the arrangement of particles are not same as in both of it. So we call that the density of the iron particle is very high, very tight, so that's why it is denser. So mostly the solids are denser, liquids are moderate denser, and the gases are very low density, having very low density. Next is rigidity and fluidity. Yes, the first these property I am going to explain, what is rigidity. Rigidity means the substance having fixed shape and fixed volume. They don't move without any action. They don't move. When you put a piece of iron on any place, you realize that it stays still here. But if you put some water, if the surface is inclined, you realize that the water is flowed up without any action. So there is the difference between the rigidity and the fluidity. Means the rigidity means the substance having fixed volume and fixed shape. They don't move without any action. So solid are rigid, liquid are flow easily, but gases are fluid and they also can flow easily. So these are the properties of solid, liquid and gases. Now in my next video, I will explain you diffusion. Thank you. Have a nice day.